I grew up in what was a relatively small city in Gainesville, Georgia, and to be able to say I've traveled the world, you know, that's something that's very special to me, and it's very meaningful.
Tasha attributes much of her success on the court and in life to lessons she learned from her mother.
When it comes to heart and passion and making sure everybody feels loved and cared for, there's nobody better than my mother. Maneuvering the challenges and still finding a way to, you know, have a kid, you know, have a job, and still be working her butt off to get her degree, you know, it helps always keep things in perspective for me as an athlete, you know, because, you know, if you're running sprints, you had a hard practice, you know, you're in the weight room, there's times where you want to tap out. You know, every athlete's been there. But when you're thinking in the back of your mind, like, well, at this age, my mom went through this, or like at this point, my mom, you know, think about everything that she's gone through, you know, it makes you maintain perspective. It makes you understand that, like, this pain is temporary. You know, glory is forever. I think at Gainesville, I prided myself on being kind of a extremely versatile player, because I grew up and my favorite player, I feel like everybody, was Michael Jordan. But then, you know, I started watching Tennessee, and that's when you fall in love with the Lady Balls and Shamiqua Holdsclaw. And I was like, oh, I like her too. And then I grew like 7 inches. So I was like, well, maybe I need to learn how to play with my back to the basket. It was the first checkbox on my list of goals that I had to accomplish. I mean, win a state championship. You know, my mom went to East Hall, so they had two. So my goal was to at least win three or more. So that was one of the first things. But also, I was dying because the night before, you know, I had gotten food poisoning. So I was in the hospital till about 2 or 3 in the morning. I don't know how I made it through that game. I guess, like I said, that community support, you know, I mean, because I remember like the whole city of Gainesville coming down there. If you wanted to rob all of us, that would have been the day, because we were down in Macon, the Red Elephants, we were thick. But it was great. And to win by my mom, you know, that's everything.
Over Humphrey's career, her Lady Red Elephants teams amassed a 114-15 record. One of those 15 losses still haunts Humphrey, the state title game loss of her sophomore year.
It was more so a humbling experience for myself. I think if I would have come in much better shape, much better place mentally and physically, that loss wouldn't have happened. You know, so going forward, I didn't want to let, you know, my community down, my teammates down, you know, my mom down, and more importantly, like, I knew I was better than that. And I think so many times, you know, we fail to humble ourselves and fail to just hold ourselves accountable for our action or inaction in this case, you know, so that was really important for me. Oh man, let's see, Jasmine Benson. You know, that we had JT Money, that was our little pick and roll scoring duo. And then Sarah Westmoreland, we spent a lot of time together at her house. And then Lauren Niles. Lauren and I, we essentially grew up together. When your teammates happen to be your best friends, you know, it makes things better. Number one would probably have to be winning that last state championship with that senior class. You know, I mean, I think it's rare that at any level or any place that a team wins 3 out of the 4 state championships, and to do that with those group of girls and to know how much fun we had and the amount of laughter and the amount of, you know, blood, sweat, and tears that we shed together was incredible. And I think the number two moment would probably be my freshman year when we were playing Hart County and I scored 45, because, you know, I took it very personal that they were the number one team in the state. So I had to make sure that we got that corrected. Anything that you love and that you're passionate about can take you anywhere you want, you know, with the right drive, the right support, I mean, part of it's luck, you know. My weapon of choice just happened to be basketball, and it took me around the world. No matter what you do, no matter what you want to do, go in and go 100%, and know that there are going to be good days, there are going to be bad days, and be prepared for that, you know?
What does it mean to Tasha to be inducted into the Hall of Fame?
It means that I'm a product of my environment, and Gainesville's legacy for a long, long time has been, you know, great athletics. You know, I mean, my mom, Gainesville product, you know, you are a Gainesville product, Micah Owens, I mean, Deshaun Watson, Chris Carpenter, like Tommy Aaron, like there's like this huge Rolodex. Because when you think about it, like I doubt that there's that many cities that have people that's played in the Major League Baseball, in the WNBA, who's played that in the NFL, that has won a Masters, you know, like, these are huge things, you know, and to know that I'm a part of that first eight is special, you know, because I know what that means here, you know, like this is elephant country, this is red elephant country, and people laugh at our mascot until we get out on that field or on that court or on, you know, the wherever, and that's just something that, you know, I'm proud of. It means everything because, you know, greatness is something that I always strive for. And, you know, I could have been at East Hall and West Hall or these other places. Just kidding. I mean, kinda.